Hey everyone, it's Bill Duran here from Punished Props, down here in the shop getting a whole bunch of stuff done for convention season 2014. San Diego Comic-Con just happened, and while I missed out on that one, unfortunately this year, Dragon Con is right around the corner in so many days I don't even want to think about it because I have a lot of work to get done. In the spirit of cosplaying at conventions, I decided to share with you guys my cosplay repair kit. As careful as we may be at conventions, stuff breaks, so it pays to be prepared. Here's how I do it. First of all, there will be a link down below to all of the tools and materials mentioned here. In fact, if you click through any of those links, it will send you to Amazon and I get a tiny cut of it. So I thank you guys for checking that out. Now onto the goods. For starters, you need a box, a toolbox, in fact. This guy right here I got for super cheap at, I think, at Harbor Freight or something. You can probably find them online. I'll have a link down below. This guy is tiny and adorable, and it fits right in my costume case. That's the costume case that I fly with all of my giant costumes. Bear in mind that this case gets checked if you're flying, because there are, I guess, potentially dangerous things in here, like sharp objects and glue and stuff. The first thing you want to have in your repair kit is spare materials for your costume. Anything that's specific and that you can't buy on hand at the convention should be in there. Little scraps of foam or Warbla, if that's what you're using. Also, any particular fabrics that you might need for your costume so that you can repair it on the fly and not have to worry about it not matching anymore. Second, probably most important thing is a hot glue gun. I have a couple of these lying around, so this guy lives right in this repair kit so that it is always ready to go when I'm going to conventions. Also, make sure you've got plenty of spare glue sticks on hand. Other than any particular tools you might need for your particular costume or prop, a multi-tool will get you most of the way there for most repair jobs, so have one of those on hand. Also, make sure you have plenty of spare adhesives. Whatever it is you used on your costume or prop, have a little bit of that with you. You can get something like a 5-minute epoxy or barge cement or super glue. What I would recommend is buying an unopened container and bringing that with you so that it doesn't get everywhere inside your box. Also, put all that stuff in a nice Ziploc bag. These guys right here will keep it from getting all over your stuff in there. The same goes for any paints or markers or anything like that. Put it in a Ziploc bag so that you don't get it everywhere when the plane depressurizes. You will also want to have some sort of sewing repair kit, a needle and thread, obviously. Although I've found most temporary on-the-fly repairs can be done with safety pins and zip ties. Another really cheap, quick repair is electrical tape. You can use it to temporarily stick one thing to another for a little while until you have an opportunity to make a more permanent repair. Finally, don't forget a bottle opener. You might say, Bill, what's a bottle opener gonna do to help me fix my costume? It won't, but when you do irreparably damage your costume and need to drown your sorrows in a bottle of wine, you wanna make sure that you've got that bottle opener on hand. That's it, you guys. There's a whole bunch more stuff. Again, go check out the link below with a full list of all the stuff I keep in my repair kit. You might have something really cool that you like in your repair kit, so why don't you let me know in the comments down below. Other than that, you guys, convention season's here. I'm cranking out some stuff. I got this big old sniper rifle here ready to go here in a couple days, so keep an eye out for that. And I believe that's gonna be a Dragon Con, so hopefully I'll see you guys there, and hopefully you will see that there. Take care, everyone.